Cultivation of viruses. Since viruses are obligate intracellular parasites, they cannot be grown on inanimate culture medium. So there are three types or methods used for cultivation of viruses. They are animal inoculation, chick embryo and tissue culture method. First one is the animal inoculation. It is the oldest method. And the animals used in this method are mice, guinea pig, hamster and rabbits. And monkeys are also used. Mice is the most commonly used animal. Because it is used for cultivation of Coxsackie virus, Togo viruses through intracerebral and intranasal route. And in this, the animals should be healthy, free from communicable diseases, and the inoculation, after the inoculation, the virus multiply in the host and then it develops the disease. After it develops the disease and either it dies or it is at the advanced stage of the disease, the virus is isolated and it is then purified from the tissue. And the live inoculation is done for human volunteers. It is the first time it is done for yellow fever virus cultivation. The advantage of this technique are it is used for diagnosis, pathogenesis and clinical symptoms to be determined, and then for the production of antibodies, and then primary isolation of certain viruses. Mice, which is more reliable model for viral replication, study of immune responses, epidemiology and oncogenesis. The disadvantages of this technique are it is expensive and there are more difficulties in maintenance, and mice do not provide models for vaccine development. It is only for used only for viral replication, and a vaccine cannot be developed from the mice. And some viruses cannot be developed by this technique, and it is difficult in choosing animal, which animal is necessary for which viruses, and there are also issues related to animal welfare systems. The second one is the inoculation into embryonated egg, or it is also called as chick embryo method. It depends on the type of the egg used for the type of the virus. And the chick embryo must be taken at 7 to 12 days old. Its cell surface is first disinfected with iodine and then penetrated with small sterile drill. After the penetration, inoculation is done and then it is then sealed with gelatin or paraffin. After sealing, it is incubated at 36 degrees Celsius for 2 to 3 days. After that, the egg will be broken and then the virus is infected. The virus is infected at a stage when the embryo is dead, or we can see the lesions on the egg membranes. And the parts of egg it is used to embryonate are chorioallantoic membrane, allantoic cavity, amniotic sac, yolk sac. In these parts, the inoculation can be done, and this technique is more advantageous than the animal inoculation. In this picture you can see the structure of the chick embryo. In this the viruses can be inoculated in the chorioallantoic membrane, amniotic cavity, yolk sac and the cell and inside the cell membrane. And the advantages of the chick embryo technique are it is widely used, and chick is the ideal substrate for viral growth and its replication, and it is also cost effective and maintenance is less, and it needs less labor, and chicks are also available widely, and it is free from contaminating bacteria and viruses, and it is also used for vaccine production. And this technique does not need feeding and caging of the chicks, and chicks do not have the immune system to counteract virus infection. Then the disadvantages are the eggs may be contaminated with the mycoplasma, and some latent fowl viruses which may contaminate it, so that it interferes the growth of the viruses. And then the susceptibility of chick embryo is limited only to few viruses. Bacterial contamination in very minute or small amount in the inoculum may also kill the embryo, so that it may not act as a host for further viral replication. So it is a major disadvantage of this technique. Then the third one is the tissue culture method. There are three major types in this technique. First one is the organ culture. It is used mainly for highly specialized parasites of certain organs. For example, tracheal ring organ culture is done for isolation of coronavirus. Tracheal ring organ culture. Then explant culture. In this, fragments of tissue can be grown as explant in plasma clot, and it is rarely used, and it is also not used in virology, and it does not give very useful effects also. Then the third one is the cell culture technique. It is the most widely used one, and the cells are grown under controlled conditions in this technique, and it is grown in vitro. In this, tissue or fragment cells are first dispersed by using proteolytic enzymes such as trypsin and mechanical shaker. And then the cells are washed and suspended in a growth medium, and then it is distributed in the petri dishes, test tubes or bottles or whatever used for culture medium. And then these cells will be adhered to the glass surface so that it grows out to form a monolayer sheet. Then it grows out to form a monolayer sheet. There are three types of cell cultures in this: primary cell culture, diploid cell strains and the continuous cell lines. The first one is the primary cell culture. In this, the cells are taken, normal cells are taken from the animal body or either from the human body, and it grows only for limited time and it cannot be maintained in serial culture. And then primary isolation of viruses is done, and it is also used for production of vaccine. Example for the primary cell culture is rhesus monkey kidney. Then human amnion cell culture, chick embryo fibroblast culture. The second one is the diploid cell culture, or it is also called as semi-continuous cell lines. It contains the diploid number of chromosomes, that is the same number of chromosomes as the parent cells, and it is capable of 100 divisions in culture, that is it undergoes serial culture. It is useful for isolation of fastidious pathogens, production of viral vaccines, and examples is human embryonic cell strain, rhesus embryo cell strain. Then the third one is the continuous cell lines. The cells are derived from the cancer cells, that is oncogenic cells, and it gives rise to successive generation. So that it is called as a continuous cell lines. A serial culture is done in this, and by transforming them from one test tube to another test tube without any changes in the character of cells. So it can be used continuously for a long period. So it is called as a continuous cell lines. And it is used for the isolation of virus, but it is not useful for vaccine production. And examples are HeLa, it is a human carcinoma of cervix cell line, and BHK21, it is a baby hamster kidney cell line. Then the detection of virus growth on cell culture. It is how the viruses growth on those cell cultures are detected. So there are certain methods or certain changes takes place which can detect the virus growth. So first one is the cytopathic effects. In this, morphological changes will take place in the virus, which shows that there is a multiplication of virus in the culture medium. For example, enteroviruses cause orientation of cells. And the second one is the metabolic inhibition. When there is growth of viruses in the culture medium, the cellular metabolism is affected, and it turns the acidic, so that it indicates the growth of viruses in the culture medium. And phenol red indicator is used to detect changes in the metabolism. Then the third one is the heme adsorption. Heme adsorption is nothing but when the influenza and the parainfluenza viruses grow in the cell culture, they adsorb to the Guinea pig RBCs onto the surface of cell culture. So this adsorption shows that there is a growth of viruses in the culture medium. Then the fourth one is the interference. In this, the growth of the first virus, which is first inoculated, it interferes with the infection of the second virus, that is the growth of the other viruses. Interference. Then the fifth one is the transformation. In this, the oncogenic viruses cause cell transformation, so that it indicates the growth of the viruses in the culture medium. Then fluorescent antibody staining method is used for detecting viral multiplication. And heme agglutination test, it is performed by tissue culture fluid for viruses like orthomyxoviruses and paramyxoviruses. The advantages of the cell culture technique is that it is relatively easy and it has broad spectrum, and it is also cheaper and it shows sensitivity. Then the disadvantages are the it requires a lot of labor and trained technicians who have to work a lot of time in it, and it needs a lot of laboratories and also high maintenance. It takes a lot of time also. So these are the three techniques which are used for the cultivation of viruses. The first one is the animal inoculation, second one is the chick embryo technique, and the third one is the culture medium. These three techniques are used for the cultivation of viruses.